Hello friends, in this video we will see the complete process of PDC. But before that, we will let you know what is PDC. PDC means post-dated check, like your customers gives you the advance check. So whenever you will generate the sale bill or creation of any outstanding, so you can deposit the checks and you can receive the amount against them. PDC is similar as advance check. There is a bit difference between PDC and advance check. Like in PDC check, there is a post date mentioned, or maybe some amount has been mentioned it, but advance checks are totally blank. So let's learn the PDC process. Firstly, we will see the process to receive PDC, for which we will go to accounts menu and will enter on PD checks cash option. As we will enter, this window will appear. In entry date, we will enter the date on which you receive PDC, then bill number. If you know the bill number, then you will mention the bill number here. Or if you don't know the bill number, then press right arrow key on the keyboard and mention the party name. Next field is PDC number. Here we will mention the PDC number. Here you will specify the PDC date and then enter the amount. Now specify here of which bank or branch the PDC is. Similarly, we receive one more PDC. Enter the PDC number, then PDC date, PDC amount, and then specify here of which bank or branch the PDC is. Then simply press end key from keyboard and save this. After receiving the PDC, next process is to deposit checks in bank, for which you have to fill the pay in slip, and for that go again on accounts menu, then from bank pay in slip to pay in slip. Now let's learn first about bank pay in slip. When we go to deposit the checks in bank, so along with it we have to fill one slip in which you fill the check details like name of the bank of which the check is, branch name, your account number, date, party details. So in this way, it almost takes your 4 to 5 minutes. And if at the same time you deposit 5, 7 or maximum 10 checks, there is no issue. But if there are checks more than 10 or some parties where you have to deposit 40 to 50 checks altogether, in that case, situation is critical. Because if one slip takes 3 to 4 minutes, then 40 to 50 slips, it will take almost 1 hour, as well as chances are increased of getting some mistakes in the slip. So for these kind of firms, bank has provided one book type format, in which this process becomes shorter and easy. On the following of this process, in Marg software, you are provided with bank pay in slip format, from which you can complete the pay-in-slip process in 1 to 2 minutes. Firstly, we will enter the deposit date on which you are depositing the check. Then, checks up to, which means of which date you are depositing the checks in bank. Then select the bank in which you are depositing the checks, like here we select Bank of Baroda. Then in slip number, here you will enter the slip number manually. As you are seeing on the screen, those checks which we have received in PDC are shown here. Now to deposit them in bank, press plus key on keyboard simply. Or if you have so many checks and you want to post them all together, then press F3. In this way, your checks are deposited in the bank, then just press escape key. Suppose you have posted the check wrongly which you don't want to. So to unpost that, go to accounts menu again, bank in pay in slip, and then enter on pay in slip, post it. Here you will enter the date, select the bank, and then enter the slip number. Now on screen, here you can see those checks which were deposited. And suppose you didn't want to deposit, but mistakenly it got deposited. So to unpost this, press minus key and unpost it. Then press escape key. When we deposit the check in bank, there are two cases. First, either your check is cleared or it is uncleared. So we will look first the process of when our check is cleared. For that, we will go to the books menu, then select bank reconciliation. Here we will select the bank to which we are doing reconcile. In account number, you will fill your account number. In account number, you will fill your account number. Then in report, select reconciliation. Then here, feed the reconciliation date on which date it is reconciling. Now you will get three options, that are reconciliation, cleared and uncleared. If you are reconciling your bank, then we will select the reconciliation. If you want to see your cleared checks, select cleared. Or if you want to see the uncleared checks at present, select uncleared. For now, we are reconciling bank, so we will select reconciliation. Here, you can see on the screen that you have received those checks which you have deposited in bank. These are two checks which we have posted earlier. Here, we will press enter, specify that date on which check is cleared. Suppose the check is cleared on 20th October 2017. Next option is hold slip. Hold slip means those checks are cleared which we have deposited in slip number 2. So from here we will do yes. The checks we have deposited in slip number 2, software will automatically show cleared checks on the same date. As you can see here, we have deposited two checks in slip number 2. So the both checks will be cleared on same date, 20th October 2017. Now press escape key. Now if you want to see the cleared checks, so you will enter on cleared and mention from which date to which date of those checks you would like to look for. Like you can see here, the checks we have cleared are shown cleared to you. And now if you want to see your uncleared checks, enter on uncleared and mention from which date to which date of those checks you would like to look for. So in this way you can see the checks are uncleared. Press escape key and it will bring you to the main screen. After this, if any of your checks are bounced, means if those are dishonored, then in that case, how we enter in mark? For this, from the accounts menu, go to checks dishonored, advances, then select check dishonored from here. Select the party of which check is bounced. Here you can see the check number. Now suppose this check is dishonored. Here mention the check number in check DD number. Feed the date on which check was uncleared. And next field is bank charges. Whenever any of our check is bounced, bank asks for an amount in terms of penalty. So in bank charge field, you will mention that amount is charged by bank. Next is party charges. That charge which bank wants to deduct, and if those charges you want to recover from your party, then mention that amount in party charges. Next is add in next bill and accounts. Means those charges you want to recover from your party and you want to add directly to their account or want to add in the next bill. Suppose we want to add it in the next bill. We will select the next bill. Here, software automatically will generate an entry against check dishonored. And the charges from you asked by bank are added here. Now simply you will save this bill. After saving it, you will get three options of PDC. Not required, check represent, save in PDC. If you are returning this check and you don't want to keep it with you, you have to select not required. Next option is check represent. If you want to represent this check to bank or in any other account you want to represent, then select checks represent option. Then is save in PDC. Now if your check is dishonored and you want to save it in PDC again, then select save in PDC. For now we will select not required. Here you will see whenever we generate the party bill, the bank charges you have mentioned in the bill, and when you will make its next bill, then software will automatically add that charged amount by bank, that was Rs. 250 into the bill. After this, the checks you have posted and you want to see, go to accounts menu, bank in pay in slip, then pay in slip posted. Now mention the deposit date on which date the checks are deposited. Select bank in which checks are deposited and enter slip number. As if we want to see checks in slip number 2, then you can see that you have deposited the checks in the bank. You can press Alt plus P simply and take a printout now, and to see preview, we'll press F. Here you can see bank statement is now open. Here fill serial number, check date, party name, bank, branch and total amount are generated automatically. Now you can show the printout and can deposit cheques in the bank easily. The same format has been provided by bank, which is uploaded in the Marg, and after using it, your work will be easier and mistake will be zero. In this manner, we have seen the complete process of PDC in Marg. Thanks for watching.